As a scientist working with brown dwarfs, I'm very interested by these results because it's another piece of the puzzle that tries to understand how exoplanets and brown dwarfs form. So in this image, you can see the Flame Nebula, which is a star-forming region. When this team analyzed this image, they identified a bunch of about 20 low-mass brown dwarfs, and these three objects as ones of the lowest mass. The population of brown dwarfs is very interesting because it constitutes the bridge between planet and stars. They're not massive enough to sustain the fusion of hydrogen in their core, so they distinguish from star, but we expect them to form as a star, so they also distinguish from planets. A cloud of dust and gas could fragment and collapse to form these brown dwarfs. The lowest mass that has been discovered is about 2 or 3 Jupiter masses. But interestingly, Webb can observe objects at even lower mass of about 0.5 Jupiter masses, but it didn't. This value of 2 or 3 Jupiter mass could potentially be the lower mass limits of objects formed by stellar mechanisms. So consequently, maybe the lowest mass limits of the population of brown dwarfs. On Earth, we have an atmosphere, which is good for us, but not to observe faint objects, because Earth absorbs a part of the light, specifically in the near infrared. But since James Webb is in space, it's not an issue for observations.